Patty was my fourth novel, and it was probably the last novel that I wrote about my family, or rather the history of my family. Before that, there were three other novels known as the Dublin Trilogy. They were The Dancer, The Gate Maker, and The Gambler, and took place between 1913 and 1958 in Dublin. It was sort of the story of my father's family. And I think I was always trying to understand that talented but complex and very, very difficult family, and what made them become the sort of people that they were. When it came to Tatty, it was very autobiographical because it is my own story. It's the story of a breakup of a marriage, and it's seen through the eyes of a child. It is completely autobiographical in that Tatty's life is her home life, her school life. Her experiences are very much my experiences, my school, my home life. There are some changes in that Tatty has two sisters, Deirdre and Jeannie, and I have no sisters. I just have four brothers. Also, I'm the eldest in my family, and Tatty is not the eldest. And I think the position is important within a family of the children. I think sometimes often when a marriage breaks up, a child can spend the rest of their lives into adulthood almost grieving for their parents' marriage and trying to understand what happened. In Tatty's case, it was a number of factors, but alcohol definitely played a large part in the breakup. Both parents suffer from abuse of alcohol. They're good people and they love each other very much, but they just can't make the marriage work. It's set in the 60s and the 70s in Ireland, and I think maybe it's the same for a lot of families around that time. Things were beginning to change for women, and that brought certain conflict too. Women were no longer happy to stay at home and wait for the man to come home or to bring her out, or to make her life solely for the children and for the man. And in my own experience with my parents, the women of that generation often felt they were liberated because they could go to the pub and because they could drink as much as the men, but that brought more problems. Tatty knows there's something wrong. She senses that there's something wrong in her family, and she tries to make sense of it in her own mind. She tries to find the reasons why. When I was a little girl, I used to lie awake at night, and I think this is what made me a writer. I would change the day in my head. I would sort of make a storyboard out of it. So if I had been bad in school, I would make myself be good in school. And I would make myself look different, and I would make myself do everything, something different that would change the course of the day, so that at the end of the day, my parents would not have a row. There would be no fight, and we would be very happy. And I felt that if I could change the story, I could change the ending of the story. And I think that's where I started to become a writer. Even now, more than 10 years later since Tatty came out, when I read from it, I can still get emotional, because I don't think we ever really get over a broken family, particularly if it's done so with so little harmony, where both parents, who have loved each other very much, perhaps too much in a way, can end up hating each other so much. It can be quite emotional for me to read it. The other factor is that Deirdre, Tatty's sister, is a child who is handicapped, who has special needs. In my case, my brother is the one who is handicapped and has special needs. And as a child, I was very much torn between a huge love for him, a huge need to protect him, but there was also a very small sense of shame in front of other children, which I still feel a little bit guilty about. But anyway, I think that's a common thing with people, with siblings, who are handicapped. And I wrote Tatty in episodes. Every chapter, she becomes a year older. So her perception changes, her voice matures, she begins to notice different things. And I think the real ultimate tragedy of Tati is that as she gets older, she begins to not believe her parents when they say everything is all right. And she becomes more and more aware that everything is all wrong. And so she's trapped within the family. I make it sound like a very sad story, and it is in many ways sad, but there's much humour. There's a lot of funny things within Tati too. And I think light and darkness sort of is needed in a novel. It's like building a house. You need enough windows to let the light in.